And we're back. Did you have a nice break? Did you talk about what you loved? Yes, me too. I'm gonna be buzzing. Who is gonna be able to sleep tonight? Not me. Watch CP24 tomorrow. Watch CP24 tomorrow. Yes, we will be talking about the Tap Dance Festival. We had some incredible press leading up to the festival, and I'd really like to thank Carrie and Danielle at Flip Publicity. They've done an incredible job with us. So that's incredible. Thank you to them. I would also like to thank, I talked a lot about being grateful to the Harborfront Center, but the three people that have been helping me out quite intensively this last month are Alyssa, Laura, and Iris. So thank you so much for all of your help getting this happen and make it a success with me. The other thing that I've been loving sitting out here in the audience, it's so nice to just enjoy. It's incredible to be able to celebrate my friends and my teachers. Don't they sound good? Right? And don't they look good? I mean, to be able to have Sharon DiGenova on this project, making sure that you can hear tap dance. If we don't hear them, we are not successful. And I'd just like to say thank you so much for the incredible tech support to make this happen. So thank you to Sharon and the crew, and everybody at Harborfront Center. It's essential. It's essential. We're not going to come out here and click for you. We want you to hear the music, right, through the whole body. So wide range we've seen so far, and we're not even done the first show. This next set, these artists came in from New York City. And I have to tell you a little story. So I've known about Heather Cornell for an incredibly long time. And there was a couple times that she came into Toronto and then the workshop didn't happen, or I missed her, or something happened. I feel like I've been chasing this woman. And then my friend Tim Poskate, who's a banjo player in town, he calls me up and he goes, "Hey, there's a show at Harborfront this afternoon." I go, okay, so? He goes, "And Heather Cornell is there." And I go, "What?" "And Heather Cornell is playing with Andy Milne." And I go, "What?" And he goes, "Yeah, what Heather Cornell to you is what Andy Milne is to me." And I go, "Okay, how much?" He goes, "Free." I'm like, "Get out of here." So I drop everything. My friend Rob, speaking of Rob Bird is one of my very dearest best friends, and he's been doing all the social media work, so all the incredible stuff you've seen on Facebook and Instagram, that's all Rob. Please give it up for Rob. So my dearest friend Rob and I, we head down to the Harborfront. Who do we see there? Travis Knights, Kathy Duncan, my friend Daryl, who plays saxophone. No one else. It's not funny. It's a huge problem. Why wasn't anybody there? Right? Like, we have these masters on stage. They're playing through the show, Finding Synesthesia. You can look that up online. There's tons of clips of it. It's incredibly touching. It's incredibly inspiring. And I hadn't met her yet. And so I see her over at the Brigantine Room, where we did the Big Band Tap Review last year, where the jam is happening this weekend and all the panel discussions over in the main building. And it was in the summer, and the door was open, and you could just waltz on in, and you have this master here in Toronto, and she's Canadian, and no one was there. I couldn't believe it. The next week, I was on my way to New York City. My mom, my dear mom, she lent me some money and said, "You go ahead." And I spent a month there. And I met Heather here, and I was very nervous to talk to her. And I said, "Hey, I'm on my way to New York, and can I call you? Can I maybe get a few lessons?" And she was like, yeah. And I was like, respectfully, "Okay, great, thanks, nice to meet you." And she wanted to talk to me, she wanted to engage with me. And Rob was like, "She doesn't want to stop talking, just keep talking to her." I was like, okay. So nervous. And we stroke up a really incredible conversation about some Eddie Brown material. And I'll never forget that conversation and how interested she was in what I thought. And that's where that began. And then I wrote a grant proposal. I've been really, really fortunate to be able to receive funding, not only for this festival, but for other projects. And my first successful grant application was to go to New York for 4 months and to study with Heather. And I also studied with Brenda Buffalino, and I studied with Max Pollock. And it really changed everything for me. It changed the game. And what it inspired me to do was build my community. and really connect with people. And I could have just stayed in New York City, but what needed to be done was some time in the shed. I had to build my technique and I had to find my sound. And after tears and tears and tears and tears with Heather, I was on my way. And a lot has changed, a lot has happened, and it's a lot of building with the community. I'm gonna talk a little bit more about what's happened here in our history in Toronto tomorrow and throughout the weekend. Heather being able to come here and help me build this community, to be able to come and build in the Toronto Rhythm Initiative shows, which I'll talk about tomorrow, it's just meant the world to me. And to have an opportunity like this, it's just, here I go. It's so meaningful for me to be able to present someone who's given me so much and is invested in this art form, priceless amounts of time into everybody that has shown the love for this dance. So that's the passage, right? Is all the masters and investing in the next generation, and it really is a multi-generational unit and a multicultural unit. And it's so important that we put those before us on stage and we pull those coming up and we all come together. So it's with great love and respect that I get to share this with you. Heather Cornell and Making Music Dance.
you. Okay, this is a big thrill for me tonight. I'm getting to come home to Canada, to Toronto, also my home, and to Harbourfront, because my first professional performance ever was 37 years ago in 1980 in the Harbourfront Theater. So, pretty cool. And thank you, Allison, for your vision, for your passion, for your artistry, and for your wisdom. Yay, Allison. We love you. So I've been very, very blessed to travel a lot from tap dancing, sharing tap dancing around the world. And my latest passion has been in South America because the music blows my mind. I was at the second Colombian tap festival 2 years ago, and I met this crazy human being over here, Antonio. And he invited me a couple months ago to the first Zap festival in Peru, meaning Zapateo. Blew my mind completely. I feel like a child again. You saw Allison crying. I've been doing that nonstop since I got back from Peru. It's an unbelievable feeling to feel like a child again and to see your whole life open up again in front of you. And I owe this to this man here. He's a wonderful human being. He's a dear friend. He's a dear collaborator now. We're sharing. I'm teaching him swing. He's teaching me Afro-Peruvian stuff. Lots of stuff. And if you get the chance, whether you dance or not, come to his class. He will blow your mind too. So from Peru, it gives me great honor to introduce to you Antonio Vilchez.
Thank you. this is the portion of the program where I take just a second to explain something. Any of you who have taken a class with Heather before would know that she's one of the biggest advocates of having live music with tap dance, because it is all the same. So I noticed a trend of more people having bands in their shows, which is great. And the funny thing is, although we have something playing without me playing right now, everything was played live tonight using some looping technology. So I gotta give it to Heather for advocating for live music, but also letting me to record my music while we play it. I think that's pretty lenient. So we also wanna introduce the band at this portion of the evening. And I know she's the reason we're all here. So I wanna give a big thank you to Heather Cornell.
Telephone and percussion. Romano on guitar.
Mateo, tap dance, cajon, taquita. Mr. Magic. Adriel Williams on all the things that are live, but not. And violin. We have one more number after this, and we expect you to get up and dance. Thank you.
you.